Welcome back to the Beginner's Guide to Python. In this lesson, we're going to learn about Python dictionaries. Dictionaries are a data type within Python that allow you to map keys to values. So you can think of dictionaries as a list of key value pairs. Let's go ahead and create our first dictionary. All right, so load up the Atom editor with the same project that we were working on in the last video, the Beginner's Guide to Python. Let's create a new file within this and let's call it dictionaries.py. All right, so let's imagine that we wanted to create a dictionary that contained a list of the apples that we have in stock and the value is the number of apples that we have in stock. So you basically have an inventory of apples and the number of amount that we have in stock. The way that you create a dictionary is you write the name of the dictionary. So let's call ours apples. And then you put equals and then you open up these curly brackets here. If you just do this, you can create an empty dictionary. But if you want to assign values to the dictionary when you first create it, what you do is you type the name of the key, and this can be a string or an integer, or a string or a number. We're going to use a string in this case because we're going to call it the name of the apples that we have in stock. So let's take one of our apples, the Cox variety of apple. And what you do is you create the key that you want, and then you use the colon, and then you tell it what value you want to assign to this key. So we're going to create a key called Cox, and we're going to assign a value of 17. So if you imagine, this is the name of the item we have in stock, and this is the number or the quantity of that item that we have available. Okay, so you can basically add as many key value pairs as you like. So you separate the key value pairs by commas. So if we do comma, Braben, and let's just say we have 21 Brabens in stock, and let's add one for Pink Lady. Say we have 7 of them, and then let's say we have Royal Gala, and we have 12 of them. Oops. And then let's say we have Fuji, and we have 1 of them. Okay, so this is our dictionary. Now, in Python, we haven't touched on this so far, but there's a recommended line length of the file. So they recommend that each line should be no longer than 79 characters. And that's what this kind of gray line is here, that atom displays for us. So it's recommended for dictionaries like this that you can actually break them down into individual lines. So you can basically put each key value pair on its own line, and then it basically makes the code look a lot cleaner and easier to read. So we're going to do that, break that down. All right, save the file. Okay. So now you can see we have a dictionary with the items that we have in stock and the number of the quantity of that item that's available. So what you do with dictionaries is you can access these values in a couple of ways. So one way, and probably the most common way, is if you wanted to output a particular value from this dictionary, then you use the square brackets to identify which key you want to retrieve the value for. So let's say we wanted to create a new variable called Cox stock. So we wanted to know how many Cox apples we have in stock. We can type Cox underscore stock equals, and then the name of our dictionary, and then the key that we want to retrieve from our dictionary. So if we want to retrieve the key for Cox, then this will retrieve the value that is currently assigned to Cox at the time of calling this line. So now we can actually print the value. So we do print, we have all right, let's save that, and then let's load up the command prompt window, and let's run our code. So we type Python dictionaries, and it's saying we cannot convert. Yes, so we basically need to wrap this cock stock in a str, and that is because, as we touched on in the previous videos, you can't merge a number or an integer value into a string. You need to convert it to a string first using this str function here. We rerun that. Got to save the file. Okay, there you can see it worked. Third time is a charm. And we have output to the screen here. We have 17 Cox apples. Okay, so that's how you retrieve an individual value from a dictionary. Let's imagine we wanted to print out every single value from the dictionary. So for this, we need to iterate over the dictionary, and then at each iteration, we need to print the value and the key that we have retrieved. So you can basically do this by typing apples or typing for apple in apples.keys, print apple. Let's save that. Okay, so what this does is it basically uses a for loop to print each key that is available in the dictionary. So this apples.keys is a function that comes with any dictionary that you create, and you can do this, you can call the keys function to list all of the keys in that dictionary. So we run this again. You can see that it outputs each and every key that we have in the dictionary. So that's one way to iterate over the dictionary. Another way is you can actually iterate with the keys and the values in the same line. So what we can do is we can type for key, or let's call this actually for apple stock count in apples.items, print, we have stock, or let's convert to a string, str stock counts, and then the name of the apple, all right, now save that. Just expand this so you can see the full line. Okay, so what this is going to do is it's going to iterate over all of the items in our dictionary, and it's going to pass into the for loop the name of the key first. So it always starts with the key, which is the apple type, and then the value, which is the amount we have in stock. So if we were to run this now, you can see that it loops through and it outputs each and every apple that we have and the number that we have in stock. So that's how you loop through the dictionaries. Another useful function in the dictionary is the get function. So the get function works just like this square bracket notation here, where it retrieves a value in the dictionary. The difference is, if the value doesn't exist, you can assign a default value. So let's say we want to know how many Macintosh apples we have. We can use the dictionary and type the dictionary name apples.get Macintosh, and we'll set the default value to 0. So what this does is it basically provides a safe way to retrieve items from the dictionary in case they don't exist. So in our case, there are no Macintosh apples in there, so we have 0 in stock. So save that, and let's just print Mac apples to see what the value is. You can see the last thing that it output was this print statement, and it says 0 because basically there is no Macintosh apples in stock. If we were to change that to 1, then it would output that value. So this is basically a useful function for retrieving values, because it allows you to retrieve values without creating any errors, because if the values don't exist, you can just basically set a default. Okay, so that's how you use Python dictionaries. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this video useful. And if you have any questions at all, please leave them in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe for notifications for future videos that we publish on this channel. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.